We're live.
Dil mein meri khwab teri tasveer jaise ho deewar pe tujh pe fida main kyun hua aata hai gussa mujhe pyar pe main lut gaya maan ke dil ka kaha main kahin ka na raha kya kahun main dil ruba burai jadoo
We're live on Facebook. Everyone who's tuning in, all the fans of Sanam, all of y'all, I'm going to give you guys a couple of minutes to tune in live to the chat. We're in conversation with Sanam the band. It's taken quite a bit of doing to get all of you guys here. Yeah. Thank you for coming to the Film Companion.
Thank you so much for having us here.
Yeah. You know, I want to start right at the very beginning and get the stats right. We're talking like 4.5 million subs on YouTube, where songs hit like, what, 80 million, 40 million, very, very casually. Listen, we're all digital content creators. We want to know what's the trick. We've locked you up in a room and we're not letting you go until you let us know. What are you guys doing right? What's the secret?
The trick is that everybody's listening to us and it's you guys. You guys are the trick. So, you know, that's where the views come from. So,
they're the trick.
Fans are the trick.
If you make music, you listen, that's trick.
Yeah.
I refuse to take an answer as simple as that. Really, how long has it taken?
You want a complex answer?
Okay, go for it. How does one...
Okay, so the algorithm is like... No, there's no like fixed thing. We just make music. We just like what we do.
The thing is, we like to keep it as simple as possible. And the main thing is to have the right intention. Mm-hmm. And our intention is to give out something very simple, something that anybody can understand. And that's another reason why we kept the name Sanam as well for the band. You know, something very easy to understand. It's not because of my name. Wo to galti se mera naam bhi Sanam ho gaya.
Set the record straight there. How long has it taken you guys? I know you're making it seem a lot easier than it actually was. How long has it taken you guys to get where you are today?
Well, we started playing, I think, together in 2010. So it's, it's close to 8 years, I'd say.
About 8 years, yeah.
It's about 8 years. And when we started off, we started playing or composing original music.
Stuff,
and we were with a label. So the scene was very different back then, because even though the digital streaming platforms were available, there was, things like iTunes.
Sure.
And there was YouTube as well.
Sure.
But the importance it has today or over the past couple of years is way more than it was back in 2010. And also the amount of people we reached is like substantially different.
Mm-hmm.
Like when we released an album, the misconception is that if you go with a label, you will get a reach automatically. The label will push you.
That's not true.
No, that is absolutely not true.
It was a scene a while ago, because that was the only way to go. And the label would put you on TV, they would put you on radio, they do everything. But that's like a select few.
But now the audience has moved to digital more than TV, so...
Exactly.
Do you guys remember the first ever song you put out on your YouTube channel? What was that day like when you upload?
Okay, the first... We put some
random videos first, like
rehearsal
videos.
Yeah.
But after that, the first music video was Teri Aankhon Se.
It's our own.
And it's a song that Summer had written, and it's actually one of our favorite songs in the band.
Yeah.
That we've put out, and a lot of people actually, our manager that manages us, Ben Thomas. He really likes that song, and even when Sanam. Met Vishal and Shekhar.
Yeah.
They were very impressed by that song, I guess.
I'm gonna ask you to sing that song. Let's just hear it. Come on.
Let's do Teri Aankhon Se. Why not?
Tera pyar nahi to पल में बुझ गई मिली आस जीने की सांसों से तेरी तेरी आंखों से अपनी नजरें हटाऊं कैसे तेरी आंखों से अपनी नजरें हटाऊं कैसे तेरी आंखों से अपनी
love it.
All right.
So many young kids watching you today think that, you know, we love what they're doing and we want to create content. We want to put it out on YouTube. We want to become social media stars. What would you tell them? Like, what should they do or not do? What are the common, like, what do you see people doing in the whole, like, I want to get famous overnight? Because it doesn't happen like that.
I think most of us are very impatient about, you know, getting there. Whatever that there is, you know, that illusionary there, as I call it. So they think, you know, if they do not reach that point, then they haven't succeeded in life. And there is no such thing called success. It's just about happiness. Happiness is what success is. If you're happy each day, means you're successful. Yeah. And that's what we all, like, you know, work for. Like to get to a point where we can be comfortable and happy. But I mean, that's the main thing. Then whatever you do, I mean, obviously without like hurting anybody and stuff, so.
But what would you tell them? Like, is it as easy to actually just start up a YouTube channel and sit on 4.5 million followers? It doesn't happen to everyone, right? So what would you want to tell them? Hang in there?
Focus on your work, right? I mean, if you're a comedian, if you're an actor, if you're a singer, if you're a dancer, focus on that. And make your product as good as you can. And I think after that, everything else will follow. Because if your product is not that great, then you put money, do whatever you want. You like, you know, beg all your friends to like it. Nothing's going to happen.
But then these days, what's great is also subjective. You know, anything becomes famous.
So,
viral.
I don't think you should take it so seriously.
Don't take it so seriously. That's the main thing. Yeah.
Chill, like have a good time.
Don't look at numbers and be like.
That's great advice.
Yeah. Just chill. Come on. Like, you know.
And speaking of famous, it's another level of fame. Like, I got spammed by multiple requests from your fan clubs to actually show up at the office. I mean, for all you know, they're probably waiting downstairs. Who knows? How do you guys maintain the line? Because there's social media. It's meant to connect you with your fans. How much do you talk back to them? And at what point do you want to maintain a line and the mystery of being an artist? How much do you engage? Where do you draw the line?
I think for all of us, it'll be different.
Yeah, it'll be different.
Again.
Let's start with you, Sanam.
Me? So, see, for me, the maximum amount of interaction that I have with fans is, you know, liking their posts, commenting on their posts, if they're like, many of them draw really, really well. So that kind, and appreciating them, you know, so like that. Okay. That's the kind. And sometimes on my post, they comment and, you know, they'll ask a question, they won't be expecting any answer, but then I'll comment, you know, at times. So it's fun.
If they're lucky day, then...
It's not about... Yeah. Don't rely on luck.
What about you guys? How much do you talk back to them?
For me also, it's the same. Like, I feel if they've put in so much effort to, like, you know, edit a picture or, like, draw or, like, you know, do stuff. Sometimes it's, like, very cute and random also. But they've put in so much effort. So if I see it, I like it. You know, I just, like, go and click the like. It takes, like, half a second to just click like. So I do that as much as I can, so...
Yeah, as long as I see anything that they put up, I try to like it or like I respond to it or share it on my social media. But there are a lot of people who don't like send messages, but they're really like they're checking every post of yours, you know. So they're those people as well. So I make sure that I'm just putting out things that I like, you know, because that's the real me.
Okay.
So if you like that, then that's who I am, you know.
Yeah, I do the same, but you know, I haven't been active for a few days now, so I'm gonna start again. I'm gonna start liking.
I think we should take a request from some of the Sanamians. Is that what
yes.
they
yeah,
call?
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Sanamians, let's Sanamians. Get a request.
Oh, okay.
Can I ask for personal
both same, okay. Similar tempo.
Can medley.
Which one? First?
Can you do it on E? Yeah.
This one?
Yeah.
That's what you're doing first. Okay.
मैं तेनू समझावा कि ना तेरे बिना लगदा जी मैं तेनू समझावा
ना तेरे बिना लगदा जी तू की जाने प्यार मेरा मैं करूं इंतजार तेरा तू दिल तू यू जान मेरी मैं तनु समझावा ना तेरे
What really fascinates me about the four of you is that you're very, very conscious about doing stuff only together as a band, despite the fact that each one of you are so popular as individual artists as well. I know you, for instance, have possibly double the following that the band has on Instagram, for instance.
No comment.
But has that been a constant decision throughout?
Yes, that has been.
See, for us, we're trying to bring back the band culture. We're trying to bring back independent music. We're trying to do something like that. So it's very important for us, for all four of us, to have to focus on the goal, and to like do stuff like that. So we do focus on doing things together, and we enjoy making music together and stuff like that. And we get our strengths from each other. So
no, but what you've actually done is made olden day songs cool for today's generation. That I think is really, really commendable. Like, was that always the plan that the music that you guys grew up on? No, that wasn't the plan.
Not really.
There's no plan, guys. I don't know what they're doing, but whatever it is, it's working.
Like, I didn't even listen to Hindi music at all. Like,
really?
For me, I was forced into singing in the first place. That is one. Then when I started singing, it was only English. And then Summer and Mummy, they would like push me into singing in Hindi because they're like, you're in India. India mein hai toh Hindi ka. And then slowly we all got together, and then this is not something we planned, obviously, like doing old songs. Only after we released Lag Ja Gale, because that also we were really scared because it's a very sensitive song.
Let's listen to Lag Ja Gale.
No. Okay, let's do that.
Okay, fine. Yeah, let's just...
Lag Ja Gale ke phir हसी रात हो ना हो शायद फिर इस जन्म मुलाकात हो ना हो लग जा गले के फिर ये हसी रात हो ना हो शायद फिर इस
Thank you guys enough for just keeping these gems relevant. If it means it going for like a couple of more generations, honestly, it's no small job at all. The fact that young millennials are singing Lag Ja Gale, well, thank you, Sanam. What's been like a crazy fan encounter? What's it like to be a boy band in today's India with social media and everything that makes
crazy
you so accessible to fans?
It keeps changing. Yeah, there's so many like.
I think I'm trying to think which one to
be.
We
got.
How about that creature thing?
That was scary. Sugar glider.
Yeah.
Those kind of messages.
Yeah.
Oh, the messages. Oh my god.
You guys are speaking a language I don't understand.
I think the biggest.
But some of them are understanding messages.
The big. The big realization came to us when we traveled outside India to places where we would think we might go for a holiday, like say Maldives or Mauritius. We never thought we'd do gigs there. We thought, okay, maybe once in our life we'll go and chill in the water there or whatever. But man, like they were like
14,000 people would come for the show.
First like time we went there, people. The president and we, I mean, Sanam dedicated, what's that song? Ye Raate Mausam.
Yeah.
Or Tu Hai Wahi, one of those two.
These oh, yeah. Both.
To the he first lady, you know.
Wow.
And the thing is that we did a version of the song with a Maldivian singer, so she's featured in our video. We shot Gulabi Aankhe there, and then we did more
we
songs.
We shot three videos there.
Yeah.
There's a fan who ordered an animal that you don't get here in India.
Ordered from Indonesia.
From Indonesia, just to gift it to Sanam. It's like really weird, like.
Yeah, and I was pretty shocked because, like, don't treat an animal like that.
Yeah, it's like.
Yeah.
I mean, and thank you for the love, but.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I appreciate your gesture, but that's not something I can accept. You know, it's.
Yeah, it's just like crazy. Yeah.
If I would, ask you guys what you'd like to change about the music scene in India.
Yeah.
What would it be?
Oh, please don't get me started. I don't want to.
You'll need a whole section on that.
Yeah, you have to do a separate interview for that, which should never come out because, yeah, things will go wrong.
Also, you guys are very diplomatic.
Have to be.
Or are we?
But sometimes have to be. Obviously, I think we're all actors. We're all acting.
Are we?
Yeah.
Our whole existence is
acting.
Or is it?
Is there a lot behind the silence, Wink?
I think once we're happy with what we've brought as a change to the scene, I think then we should comment about, like, you know,
what
we'd like other people to change.
Yeah.
You have to figure out your thing first. See? You know what you can contribute.
Diplomatic actor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Egoistic. don't get us started. Please change the topic right now. Just ask another question. Jaldi usse pehle kuch mere muh se nikalna shuru ho jaye. Jaldi.
Done deal. Let the safest thing to do is to just make you guys sing now. So I'm gonna ask you a bunch of questions and you just gotta sing in response.
Yes.
Tell me your most viewed song on YouTube right now. Can we listen to it?
We just did it.
So let's listen to your latest song.
Come on.
No plug at all.
Yeah.
Are you doing an A minor? Is it A minor?
B minor. Oh, sorry. Haan, achha, koi bhi chalega.
Achha. Okay, just whatever it is.
B minor.
Bhigi bhigi raaton mein phir tum aa.
One song that you want to wrap up this chat with? Maybe the song that you had the most fun shooting?
Again, we finished.
We all just come back to that.
Okay, second most fun.
I think Hey Apna Dil To Awara was fun.
So sorry about that. Okay, so we're going to do Hey Apna Dil To Awara.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey Apna Dil To Awara Na Jaane पे आएगा है अपना दिल तो आवारा ना जाने किस पे आएगा ओ, 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 ओ
किस पे आएगा है अपना दिल तो आवारा न जाने किस पे आएगा ओ ओ ओ ओ ओ ओ ओ ओ ओ कल न दिखा सारा है सब का सहारा ये दिल ही हमारा हुआ ना किसी का सहारा ये दिल ही हमारा हुआ ना किसी का सफर में है ये बंजारा ना जाने किस पे आएगा है अपना दिल तो आवारा ना जाने किस पे आएगा ओ
Why not? Thank you guys.
Thank you
so much. What a fun, nostalgic trip it's been, and I love that it's so relevant even today. Really, really, only thanks to you guys.
Thank you so much, and thank you for letting us play a short version of Apna Dil To Awara.
Thanks so much for coming by the Film Companion office.
Hi guys, this is Keshav Dhanraj.
I'm Venki S.
I'm Sanam Puri.
I'm Samar Puri.
And we are Sanam. Subscribe to Film Companion.
Subscribe.
Zarur karna.